se me tocó. Five, and there's three, one, and there's three, one. projects. But they also have to put on more. Of every animal in the world, and seven of the clean animals, but also food. Food enough to feed them all for a when he told them what he was going to do. Those neighbors thought it was for the boat, so it's a long way. Noah was a good man, and he did what God told him. He brought the animals, and he tackled and then God. The streams and the rivers and every rocky path, every patch of muddy earth had disappeared beneath the water. It floated over the houses, it floated over the trees, it floated over the hills and then over the mountains too. It floated for days and weeks. The water was going down, but the world was far from dry. I have here animals running with the app. He's got a big friend to Tommy, who's busy over there, and he's got little instructions. So if you don't know how to make a rabbit, or is there a boat as well? There is a boat. Hold your boat, Dad. Your ark. Brilliant. And Noah looks out the window, and there's still got water around. He doesn't know if it's there it is. The dove flew off. But eventually, it sent the dove off. And it came back because it found a dry place in its nest. Finally, God said, come out to the boat. The world is dry, the world is clean, and you and your family are filled with life again. Pray, Noah tells us. And he thanks God for staying with him. God. Promise that he would never again
think about how you wake up. Can make a rainbow with all the different colours. Now my children point out to me that I cut the rainbow the wrong way round. So you can put the rainbow whichever way round you like. You can make to remind us of what we can give thanks to God for. And in there you'll find little discs and things to stick on. And you can write on the back of these perhaps things that you're thankful for, maybe families, maybe food, all sorts of things. Thank you.
Noah came out of the ark. And harvest would be a really fascinating in Genesis and chapter 8. God says, never again because of man, even though the inclinations of his heart are evil. Never again will I destroy all living creatures as I have done. As long as the earth endures, time of harvest, summer and winter, day and night will never cease. And then God goes on to say, this is the sign of the promise. I beg you to be in you and every living creature with you. I set my bow in the clouds. Appears in the clouds, I'll speak. Then for the everlasting covenant of God and all the living creatures every time. Once again, this is the sign of the covenant I establish between me and all my sons. So the rainbow then is the sign of that promise. God is faithful. God himself takes
with endurance. The bow, the arrows are pointing not at us, but rather God himself. It's the penalty that he has in the past. And God's bow is loose. God will bring it on our finger, reject it. But rather,
the others of Jesus.
What happens on the cross is
God's love. He bears the punishment that should have belonged to us. And so he speaks to him in the dark against him. It's hard. It's like
dark. Does God really love me?
God
is in the sky and is faithless.
God
is on the sun. That's all it's wrong. Into us
Thank you.
your seats all the time, you'll
forget that the student registered it to you, and then you can see it as well.
Now, God Himself, the God of peace, sanctify you through your spirit, for your whole spirit, soul, and body. Grace of our Lord Jesus.